I'm helping to solve a challenging problem. To get a sense of it, I want you to think about the toilet that you use on a daily basis. Chances are the product that you thought of looks a lot like this. It's clean, private, convenient, and actually pretty sleek. But this product is also very expensive because you need a lot of water flowing through a network of pipes to make it work properly. In urban slums, where currently 1 billion people live, that doesn't exist. So where do people go? Often, they're forced to defecate in the open or in plastic bags, resulting in untreated waste and garbage in local waterways. The public and environmental impacts can be extreme. In Haiti alone, more than 770,000 people have been affected with cholera, and more than 9,200 have died since 2010. If people don't defecate in the open, they're stuck with pit latrines, which are expensive and typically must be emptied manually. This is a dangerous and degrading job. Residents in urban slums need a better option, one that is private, clean, convenient, and safe, like the toilets we all enjoy at home. Container-based sanitation, or CBS, is such an option. Working in collaboration with Soil, an NGO in Haiti, we designed and researched a sanitation service that doesn't need water to function, and more importantly, keeps fecal waste out of waterways in the community environment. This is one of more than 1,000 toilets that Soil is currently deployed in Haiti. These toilets are compact to fit in the tight spaces of small houses. They're easy to clean, pleasant to use, and they smell nice. What's more, the toilets are portable, which means residents can take the toilet with them instead of losing their investment if they have to move. During the recent hurricanes in Haiti, residents have been able to safely seal waste in their toilets while floodwaters rose around them. Despite this inundation of water that created serious public health issues, Soil service continued to operate safely in impacted areas. Soil deploys a full service, where waste is collected from users once a week, hauled to a treatment site, and converted into valuable compost. Soil finances the service by collecting a modest user fee from the residents and by selling the compost to agriculture. This waterless collection, treatment, and reuse system means that waterways and communities are kept clean, resulting in significant improvements in public and environmental health. But this system is not only being used overseas. Here in Oregon, the city of Portland is promoting a twin bucket system for disaster preparedness, especially in the case of something like the Cascadia earthquake, where sanitation systems might be knocked offline for as long as several months. Additionally, my future work is starting to look at how we can use these systems to provide sanitation services to homeless populations, who are often deprived of clean, private, dignified places to use the bathroom.